This is our handrail mowing machine. It's part of our stair equipment product line that we have. It's an accessory machine. It goes along with the bullnose saw, the SSR, which is our stair router for doing your box stairs. We also have the OSS, which is the open stringer saw, and the wedge cutter, as well as the 22-pin assembly cable. Okay, real quick here, I'm going to go through the basic operations of this machine. Really simple, easy to operate, easy to maintain. Real quick, on this side of the machine, we actually have a quick disconnect on the back side of the machine, and then we have a on and off button, start and stop, that's it. Real simple there as far as electrical goes. For the most part, let's say you've got your handrail, for example, you're going to have different widths, different heights. Things change, requirements are different all across the country. What we have for you is we've got a screw system here. We actually have six total wheels that are actually here. You come in and squeeze along the side as a guide. Okay, you're going to squeeze along the side with the wheels. And these are all adjustable. As you unscrew this, all the wheels start to pull and separate and come apart. And as you can see, you can get fairly wide with this. Give you some idea of just how wide we can actually go. Right now we're beyond 6 inches, which is more than anybody's ever going to need. There's always that rare opportunity. But I'm going to get this back into place. Screw works nice and simple. We also have two cylinders to come down, clamp against the working surface, hold the material down, as it actually stores up really quick. Ideally what you're going to do is take your handrail, get it into place, and take your screw and actually tighten right up against it. You can feel it tighten right away. And you're there. Now it runs back and forth. It doesn't want to slip out. It will guide you all. Now you say, how are you going to do this, y'all? Initially what's going to happen is you're going to measure and say, well, how far do I want the handrail to stick out? Okay? And then where do you want your first and second holes? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and measure that out so I have a starting reference point. I'll show you here real quick. We also have a scale for the degrees that we're going to do down here on the lower portion of the frame, and I'll explain it to you here in just a moment. But for the most part, I'm making two marks. I actually have a reference mark on the table surface. Probably not going to be able to see that in the video, but the operator, it's clearly visible for the operator. First thing I'm going to do is actually run it through so my first stop comes along this stride mark on the working surface. I have a quick catch stop on the table itself. So after I drill my first hole, what's going to happen is I advance it till it hits that quick stop, and that's the distance I have between each one of the two holes. I'm going to go ahead and run this a little bit, show you what's going on here. Get off the roller, get it into place. I've got a foot pedal down on the floor. All you have to do is depress it, clamp to come down, push everything against the working surface, and the bit will start to rise and go through the handrail. That's what I'm going to do right now. Shoulders went down. Get the direct drive. Release this thing. Maybe you can hear that, maybe you can't. What I've actually done is I've advanced it, and the hole I just drilled, pin comes up from the bottom and references it as my stop, so I can keep my distance consistent every time. Once I hit the pin, I hear it click in place, I pull it back, that is my stop, and I'm ready to go. I've got several of them here for you. Get some ideas of how quickly this machine operates. This time it's the same thing. Clicks in place on the stop. Cylinders clamp into place. I'll go through the degree here in just a minute for you. I'll do a couple more, I'll pull it out and I'll let you see just how well we're doing here. Direct drive right on the motor. No fancy collets, nice and simple. I'm going to go ahead and run this right on through, pull this back out so everyone can see what's in. Try and get a good shot of this. But what's actually going on, I've got consistent each and every time what's going on. Get a good shot at it. Real quick, I'm gonna set this down. I'm gonna go through the angle here. How do you set the angle, for example? Well, let's pick on a real common dimension. You may or may not be able to see this in the video, but the scale's down here to determine what degree we need to be at. Well, how are we gonna do that? The chart actually indicates you're gonna say your riser height on the left-hand side, and your tread width in inches is on the top-hand portion of the scale. These are fairly common scales. A lot of guys have cheat sheets in their pockets. But to figure this drill, we're gonna say 7-11. So I'm gonna say 7, I come clear over to 11. And it tells me 32 and a half. And all I have to do is break this loose, put your hand on to break that loose. This actually slides back and forth quite easily. And I'm gonna say 32 and a half. I've got a pointer scale, a piece of plexiglass glass with an arrow on it, and a scale down at the bottom, and that gives me the correct degree that I need. I'm going from 0 to 45 as far as degrees go. Works real simple. The scale is not in. The scale actually, for the degrees, goes from half, quarter, eighth, all the way to 16 of a degree, actually. Lock it in place, make sure it's tight. It's also a quick change handle for left and right hand people. You kind of hear it now clicking when they run that one last time. You can hear your mind. Simple operation. Low degree, low mass. In feet, out feet, repair. Yeah, this is an accessory machine. We have a bulldoze saw, the SSR, 4210 stair clamp, 4210 stair wedge machine. As well as the OSS, which are the open corner saws from the manufacturer. This is the last little drill. I'll turn it back over one more time so everyone can see it. I'm going to go ahead and shut the power off. Red button's stop. And there we go. And everything is actually drilled at the right angle. You can see it going in. Once again, this is the handrail boring machine. My name is Russ Merrick. I'd like to thank you for your time. If you have any questions, please call the factory at 1-800-568-7423. Once again, thank you.